This is West Point, one of Monrovia's slum areas. It's dawn, and hundreds of women are here to get the drugs that will give them and their families 1 month's protection against malaria.
She said because of Ebola, no hospital open. So when the children get sick, what they do, they mash the pepper, and then just pepper the children with air so that they can get well because there are no malaria medicine.
Over the next 3 months, 300,000 Monrovians will be given the drugs they need to protect them against malaria. These people live in the most densely populated and deprived neighbourhoods in the city. The programme is designed to prevent malaria and young children dying from the disease. However, early symptoms of malaria and Ebola are similar, so the aim is also to avoid people who think they may have hemorrhagic fever going to the Ebola treatment centres and risk coming in contact with infected patients. But organising distributions during an Ebola epidemic is not that simple, and care must be taken to ensure people don't get infected.
The first rule is to protect ourselves and all members of the team to make sure we don't get infected. We try to organize small, women-only groups. They come at dawn when most of the population aren't up yet. Over 1,000 people stand in line for hours at a time without touching each other or us. They keep a distance of about 1.5 meters to avoid any physical contact.
Similarly, another MSF team has organized the distribution of home protection kits, buckets containing protective gloves and masks and bleach.
Whenever someone is sick, I will run away from them. I will be able to take good care of them.
Over 16,000 kits have already been distributed. The kits contain everything families need to protect themselves until the infected person gets admitted to a treatment center.